Today in Teen Talk, the jocks, the band geeks, the nerds, the burnouts, probably in any sort of high school movie you've heard of these names, but we got together with four local students at the Prescott Library at the Wheeler School to get the truth behind cliques. Okay, so you guys each come from different schools all over this state, and I know that it's hard in high school. There's always cliques. There's always people that group together. There's always like the jocks and the nerds and the popular girls and whatever. Do you feel like there are cliques in your school, and do you also feel like you fall into a clique, whether you want to or not?
Yeah.
Yeah,
definitely,
you do.
Yeah. When you got sports, it's just you got the big team, then you're battling against another sport, whoever's there, and basically from there, you're in your place.
So do you feel like people label you as you're like, oh, that's Jacob, he's a jock. Like that's...
Nah, I wouldn't say the jock.
No.
Not on that level.
So you don't feel like people, you know, kind of pigeonhole you into one thing.
They just look at me like, you guys better win something this year.
Pressure's on.
Yeah.
Yeah. How about the rest of you?
I don't feel like there's a lot of pigeonholing at Wheeler, just because it's a fairly small school, and it's very community-based, and there's just so much that someone can do that you can't just say, oh, he does one thing, or she's only an actress, but because you can also play sports. It's really easy to get into sports and acting and academics, and it's just, and also because it's small, it's tough to just separate into these small groups, and everybody's always colliding with each other and having different interactions and making friendships in different places. So I feel like there's a very healthy environment.
Very similar to PCD, where you have so many opportunities to be a leader in some area and in multiple areas, so you really can't fall into one category as we are so small.
Yeah, my school's really small. There's like 150 of us in like the whole high school, so it's like, and it's not like the dancers hang with the dancers, the theater majors hang with the, it's like everyone's just like there, and like all, I know all the performances because we have different school performances. Everyone goes, like, even though the art majors, they don't have performances like where you're gonna sit and draw on stage.
do they have gallery showings?
Sometimes, yeah, but they rarely ever do. It's weird. Like, I think they would a little bit more. They should, because we have a lot of cool artists too. But like, we all go to each other's performances, or like the theater, music, and dance majors all perform at one thing, like our spring concert or something like that. And it's like, there's not really any cliques. We're just kind of a big
fan. Supportive.
Yeah.
You guys should all collaborate and do like dance act painting or something.
That'd be cool.
One big show.
Do you
feel like that's kind of a thing of the past? I mean, because you look at all these movies. I mean, let's be serious. They're always grouping people together. Do you feel like that's kind of fading out now?
I think so.
Yeah.
I think in at least the smaller schools, but it seems like even in Hope that it's kind of panning out.
Yeah.
Why? I mean, why do you think that everyone's kind of getting past that?
More maturity, I guess.
Maybe there's just more recognition of it. I don't know.
Where bullying, stuff like that.
Yeah.
Are you glad that you guys don't have those in your school and everyone's just kind of seen as equal?
Yeah, definitely.
It makes a much healthier environment, and you feel like you're
more comfortable.
Welcome, more comfortable.
Kind of express yourself.
You have more freedom and independence to just do what you want to do, and you don't feel limited by, oh, I have to stick to this because this is what I'm a jock or I'm a nerd. I have to do this. I can't do something else.
Yeah. It's pretty nice to hear that the idea of cliques has begun to fade out. And don't forget, we will be talking to our teens each day this week. And to read more about Allie, Drew, Kiana, and Jacob, check out their bios on WPRI.com.